Las Venturas. The city of gold. Sin fucking city. Whatever you want to call it, it has casinos open 24/7, shops, restaurants and more. But there is something else that is 24 hours. Give it a guess. No, you idiot. It's not the news channel. It's crime. Homicide. Robbery. And illegal gambling.
Please, please, don't you move, you motherfucker!
This gambling bus got me promoted to detective, you believe that?
You've only been with us a short time and you've assembled yourself a stellar arrest record. Not to mention the fine work you did in the war, sending heathens back to the hell they came from.
My partner, Detective Kevin H. Smith.
Yeah, I worked in these streets for 2 fucking years to get a detective. And this fucking jackass gets it in 8 months. We got moved over to Los Santos.
We had suspicion that Carl Johnson, a millionaire who lives in the hills, worked with Grove Street to traffic cocaine. So this is chapter 1.
LSPD, open up. This is the LSPD, we want to have a talk.
You have a nice estate, Mr. Carl Johnson.
I'm a businessman, and this is my business.
That's why we came here, because we have suspicion that you are running, you know, a drug cartel.
Huh? What?
Look, all we are asking you to do is give us the names, all right?
Fuck off!
What a fucker.
The thing is, we got kicked out of the mansion not because of the questions, but because of the fact that we had no warrant. So guess what? The next day we got a warrant, but he was out of town for a few days, so we...
Mr. Johnson, we have a search warrant.
We have been here for like 1 hour now. He is probably out of town.
How the fuck are we supposed to be sure of that?
He is always here at 4:30 p.m.
Yeah, I guess you are right.
We have that search warrant, which means we can wire down this place, right?
Pretty much.
Put one under his desk. Put this one in the bookshelf. Make sure they are hidden properly. Put a 3-volt suppressor on.
When the idiot came back, he had a meeting.
He invited all the bosses. They talked important stuff. We even got a few names.
What? It's my constitutional right, bitch.
Come on, homie. I got friends in high place.
For the homies, I gotta be honest with you, CJ. We could be getting into some heavy shit, baby.
What you into, Smoke?
A lot of shit about to go down, Carl. Families coming back, ballers pushing base, rushing cats with nothing to lose about to bust some ass.
For real?
For real.
Yeah. Hey, listen to me, bitch. Take me back to Grove Street.
I'm down, dog.
Fucking amazing. Not only did we finally get the boss names, but we also got the location of the factory. However, before we could actually do any moves or raid the factory, we had to send an agent way the fuck out into Las Venturas so the evidence could be proven to be true. Let's hope this fucking evidence is cocaine. Fucking plane got hit 3 times.
Bad luck, man. Well, for the agent and the pilot at least.
We knew who placed the bombs. The wires got disconnected earlier, and so they put 3 bombs on this plane to destroy the evidence. But they succeeded in destroying the backup evidence. The department has a little rule, and it is small in the outside but big in the office. Never send the original evidence over to the headquarters. Always send a copy or a backup. And you are wondering why? It's because of shit like this. You always want to play it safe. Any little slip or fuck up, and they will eat you alive and burn the evidence, like vultures in the desert. So do you think we should go to the headquarters
to deliver the evidence?
Think about it, we deliver the evidence today. By tomorrow we could raid the spot.
Okay, let's say we get the evidence approved. Why the fuck would you risk your life for a few midget gangsters? We are FIB, not SWAT, and definitely not the army.
You ever went to Vietnam?
No, and what does Vietnam have to do with this?
If we don't strike by our own hands, they will fuck everything up into shit. You think SWAT can take care of them?
Yes, I do think they can take care of shit.
I think not, and let me tell you why. They don't go in for arrests. They hold those AK-47s ready to kill once they open that door. Also, don't forget we are LSPD, not FIB. We don't shoot and ask questions later. It is not even the opposite. We should be arresting, not shooting, okay? If we want to shoot and ask questions later, we can go back in time and go to Vietnam where we shot every rat that crossed the street.
Are you done lecturing me about this shit?
Yes, I am.
So let's get the fuck moving. You know the chief won't let you raid without firearm.
I am aware, but I also don't give a shit.
Well, at least I will have a new partner by the end of the raid.
Transfers take 2 weeks, so you will be solo for a while.
Is it too hard to hold a fucking gun? It is the Second Amendment.
So what is your point?
My point is I will get you to kill someone in the raid.
Good luck on that.
What? It's my constitutional right, bitch. See? I got a gun.
Slow down, man.
You spend too long in the sun, moron.
Blast on these fools. Lay those fools out.
Motherfucking bitch.
I heard you are a decent pilot.
Why do you ask?
I am investigating a drug cartel, so I need to take some air pictures of an area and I thought you could pilot the jet.
What drug cartel?
It is classified information.
Then I won't pilot the plane. I need to know the risks.
It is called Grove Street.
Not those motherfuckers. My head will be on a silver plate if I help you.
What reward do you want? I can get shit done.
A job in the police department.
They have a delivery officer's spot open. You basically deliver evidence to the main department in Venturas.
It is located in the southwest of Los Santos.
I hope I do not get killed for this man.
Those idiots don't touch agents.
I sure hope that is true.
Once we get this evidence, I will have you deliver the evidence to the main department. So you will be an official agent, thus you are protected.
We are nearby.
Make sure you keep a steady angle so I can take good pictures.
Cessna 175, you are flying without authorization. We demand you return to base immediately.
You got the pictures. Yes, that's enough. Let's get back to base.
So you got pictures of the area while you were off duty?
Yes, and coordinates.
Who piloted the operation?
Why do you care?
I must file a report for the evidence so we can give it in.
Okay, I will tell you. His name was Hernandez.
Why do you say was?
Because he is.
He is dead.
He got promoted to evidence delivery.
Wait, are we talking about that plane crash?
Yes, I underestimated how far they would go.
Well, as long as he was on duty, it is not our fault.
Apparently he told everyone in his neighborhood about his promotion. Some cholo motherfucker informed the higher-ups at Grove Street.
See, this is why we should never promote Mexicans. So what do they call you?
I call myself the lost and found guy.
What purpose do you serve in this factory?
I collect lost tools and I repair equipment.
Why is this factory empty?
No! Help me! Call me a lawyer!
We all have the right to remain stupid. Let's do this nice and easy, missy.
We spent a lot of time for you, homeboy. We will shove a nightstick up your ass if you don't give us information.
I got friends in high places. I know your boss, officer. I can assure you this is a mistake.
Well, you didn't get me to kill anyone.
Shut the fuck up and help me get this fat fuck to the department.
We interrogated him for almost 2 days. At first he didn't want to cooperate. He had that no snitching rule, like those other gangbangers. Vinewood Dramas portrayed it like a serious thing, which made me think it stayed in the movies only. But movies come with influence and those gangbangers hit those streets instead of those college books. I don't like to judge mentalities, but those mentalities gave me this job, so I cannot really say shit. Anyways, he agreed to talk if he got witness protection. Well, we did catch him in a drug factory. We could not find sufficient evidence to prove that he was doing drugs. He was not on drugs. He did not have drugs on him, and most surprising of all, he had licensed firearm. Even though we could have let him go, but he was going to get shot the minute he was out of the station. So what information did he give us?
Thank you. You're under arrest, shithead. You're mine, buddy.
You can't stop me, punk-ass cop bitch.
Move a muscle and you die.
Fuck you, asshole. You just ruined your life, bitch.
No, I am getting a promotion now. Shut the fuck up and let me cuff you.
You should gangbang those college books the next time.
You a comedian, asshole?
If only we had that other one, too.
Yeah, it is only a matter of time before we will catch him.
And just like that, we seized his mansion, his drugs, and his money. He ended up being useless to us, but we had everything anyways. He got a 60-year sentence with 3 chances of parole, but he ended up serving none. Why do I say that, you might ask? Ryder came out of hiding just to publicly assassinate his former friend. He got sentenced to death by electric chair. And what happened to Detective Kevin H. Smith? He got moved to the East Coast. And what happened to me? I got moved over to San Fierro. I got into a big investigation, some kind of serial killer on the run type of shit. In the end, we took down one of the biggest crime families in the state.